Let's take a specific instance of this to try to clarify things for me and for the audience. A program like this. Mm-hmm. Now, there are images of you and me going out there. We're also talking.
Mm-hmm.
What's the message?
The message, in the sense that the whole effect of the medium of TV upon them is this, that with TV, the audience becomes the screen, not the camera. They pick us up by way of being the screen. We impinge upon their senses as the movie image impinges on the screen. They are the vanishing point.
Mm-hmm.
And the effect of being the receiving end or the vanishing point of imagery, the exact reverse of the movie, is to turn people inward in depth, meditatively.
Well, this is, if I understand you, this is a rather a sad moment, though, because here we are engaging in what we hope is a cerebral process, and the part of it that the cerebral process really doesn't matter much, does it?
Hold on, let's say that. What is happening since TV is that the cerebral is becoming much deeper, more profound than it had been before TV.
Ah, now this deeper or profounder thing, what is deep about getting some sort of impression of us as opposed to understanding what we're saying?
What is deep in psychology as compared with just psychological classification? It consists in relating things to one another unexpectedly. Depth, it does not mean making profound observations. It means relating perfectly obvious things to perfectly obvious things. Depth is a matter of interrelating. TV is a profound depth medium because it interrelates rather than isolates points of view. Instead of isolating a small aspect, a tiny splinter of a situation, it creates a kind of iconic surround. That is why a TV is a very fuzzy image as compared with movie.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the TV thinker may seem fuzzy because he doesn't have a point of view. He is mainly concerned with processes. When I come south of the border, I realize I have to change from process to process. But TV is a profound process medium. And in everything that's been happening to our youngsters since TV, puzzling to their parents, is this depth involvement in processes,
mm-hmm.
which they cannot find in the schoolroom.
As I understand your analysis, this is a rather uncontrollable process. That is, that you and I really can't be sure by doing this, that, or the other thing that we are going to create this, that, or the other process out there.
I think you can if you take time to study it. But you see, mostly when people are playing with TV, they think of it as, in terms of the old medium, movie. The content of TV is thought of as the movie. And they don't watch the TV form, therefore they don't attempt to control TV. They control the movie form while using TV.
But if this is a kind of almost poetic relationship between the people on TV and the audience out there, it does not operate according to mechanisms which are totally understandable by a rational process and therefore are not controllable, are they?
I think, on the contrary, it's very controllable, very understandable if attention is paid.